front of the Odeon Leicester Square for tonight's Royal Film Performance. The cheers, how happy the crowds are. To see everyone. First of all, Queen Elizabeth, the Queen Mother. The pipers are piping, what a joyous sound that is. Prince Charles and the Princess of Wales. Being greeted by Alan Harris Quelch, the manager of the Odeon, greeting Prince Charles and the Princess of Wales. A wonderful welcome for a very wonderful lady. There's Princess Anne and her husband, Captain Mark Phillips, all coming into the cinema together. Oh my goodness, there were ever so many flashes going off at one time. The good news, they walk into the foyer. Sydney Samuelson there being introduced by Alan Harris-Quelch, being presented to the Queen Mother. He will, in fact, introduce the first lineup, many of them trustees of the Cinema and Television Benevolent Fund, first of all. And Sydney Samuelson, as president of the CTBF, introducing his wife, Doris. The Countess Mountbatten of Burma. Oh, lovely greeting, of course, for the Countess. Brian Cargill. And standing beside him, his wife, Jenny Cargill. Smiles all round tonight for a lovely occasion. Sir John Wolfe with his wife, Lady Wolfe. Alex Bernstein. And his wife, Vanessa. And finally, in this lineup, all trustees of the CTBF, Percy Livingston. As the Queen Mother begins to go up the stairs, we see the Princess of Wales. See now Percy Livingston. She too is starting to move up to a lovely black velvet cape. Going up the stairs now, Alan Harris-Quelch leading the way. Beautiful, soft, lilac blue dress. And these diamonds on Queen Mother's tiara, necklace, brooches and bracelets. A truly wonderful lady, loved by everyone. Sydney Samuelson making the first of the presentations. The Queen Mother waiting for other members of the royal party. And a beautiful shade of green for the Princess of Wales. And this is His Excellency the Acting High Commissioner for India, Mr. Ramesh Arora, and his wife, Mrs. Viney Arora, has been here since January of this year. Other people in the lineup waiting. Peter Laister, who's chairman of Thorn nearby. Al Smiling Face of the Queen Mother greeting Gary Dartnell, chairman of Thorn EMI Screen Entertainment Limited, masterminding British Film Year, which is being launched tonight, and Tom Nicholas, chairman of Columbia EMI Warner Film Distributors Limited, a past chief barker of the Variety Club. So you can see Peter Laister talking with the Princess of Wales. Patrick Meaney is chairman of the RAC organisation. You can see the people waiting behind. Lord Braben, co-producer of A Passage to India. Princess Anne, beautiful dress of silver grey, very prettily formed sleeves, ruffles around the neckline. Captain Mark Phillips, we come back up now and see all members of the royal party tonight. Richard Goodwin there, a co-producer of the film, has just been speaking with the Queen Mother. And now, just in the corner of the picture, Sir David Lee, knighted last year in the Queen's First Honours list, Lady Lean. She's helped her husband on research and scripting, working for 3.5 years now on the passage to India. And Giles. Intense conversation going on between Princess Diana and Richard Goodwin. Dangling earrings, beautifully catching the light there. Dilys Powell, the renowned film critic, speaking with the Queen Mother. And Colin Young, director of the National Film and Television School since its inception in 1970. And Brian Cargill, Thames Television, of course, one of the trustees of the CTVF, making presentations to the Prince of Wales. And Princess Diana talking to Dilys Powell, who's seen the film twice and loved it. And obviously is very happy to see it again. Penelope Keith, who is delighted, she says, in just doing gardening at the moment. They're having a chuckle, which is nice. He's talking about propagating Elyon, her husband Rodney being presented as well. And Prince Charles having a word with Sir David Lee. Jenny Agata, who is working on a television series of Silas Marner in the Cotswolds at the moment with Ben Kingsley. James Fox. Prince Charles with Dilys Powell is having a lovely talk with several members of the royal family. You can see all the photographers and their great interest. Princess Anne looking delightful with her four rows of pearls, talking to Richard Goodwin. A smiling Princess of Wales. Seems to have had her hair cut a little, I hope. And there's Nigel Havers. And now it's Sir David Lee's turn to talk with Princess Anne. Victor Banerjee. He's the leading role of Doctor Aziz in The Passage to India. His first big, in fact, his first film in the West, A Star in India. This is a film, of course, which could bring him international stardom. Art Malik standing in front of the picture, waiting now to be presented to Prince Charles, and Judy Davis, Gerla Clested in the film's major part, talking quite relaxed to Malik, and an intense conversation going on between Prince Charles and Penelope Keith. It's quite a serious conversation at this moment too for Princess of Wales with Art Malik. Suzanne, who's been taken around the lineup by Alex Bernstein. It's always so nice to see the concern with which members of the royal family always talk to people represented to them. They do such homework. The stark makeup that Judy Davis is wearing, rather.
Sorry about that. Okay,
dark plum kind of lipstick with a dark suit.
No, I'm just doing something in Australia. And I'm hoping you might come to the
conversation
in
between.
It's in Melbourne.
And Nigel Havers plays the city magistrate in the passage to India, whose parents are here this evening. And one of the bouquets being presented now, first of all to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth, the Queen Mother, by Meenakshi Arora, who's daughter of the Acting High Commissioner for India. These poses are similar to the ones that were given in the film to Adela. Sylvia Davidson, who's done the flowers for the Premier, wanted to make them as close as possible to those in the film. The Queen Mother talking with Pooja Narang, who's 9 years old, and Nivedita Kulkarni. Captain Mark Phillips, taken around the lineup by Percy Livingston. Coming up now to Wendy Gowley, who comes from the Midlands, is secretary of the Birmingham Committee for the CTBF. Princess Anne with James Fox. And standing in the background, Alex Bernstein. Mixture of all the talking and chanting, thoroughly enjoying the preamble to the royal film performance. Beautiful dress over one shoulder for the Princess of Wales, with this elaborate bow sparkling emote scattered over the soft green dress. Miss Charles with Nigel Havers. His moustache and long hair coming off to Wales, he said, after his film in Australia. And Judy Davis. Now the Princess of Wales accepting a lovely bouquet of rosebuds from Pooja Narang, his daughter of the Wing Commander, M.P. Narang, his deputy air advisor at the Indian High Commission. Princess of Wales checking where everybody else is in the lineup. Waiting to see how soon they'll be moving into the auditorium. Princess Anne's hairstyle, which was so successful at the BAFTA Awards. I didn't see any red streaks on it tonight, though. Meeting Nigel Havers. A tremendous interest in films the Princess has. As president of the Academy. We saw her at the BAFTA Awards not so long ago. And of course, it's the American Academy Awards next Monday. With Brian Cargill there, who is making the presentations to Prince Charles. The passage to India is up for no less than 11 Oscars. Week tonight in Hollywood, those Oscars will be given. Close up with Judy Davis, with Prince Charles. Moments to treasure for always, I think. Mother talking to Sidney Samuelson, president of the CTBF, turning around now. we have five members of the royal family. The Queen Mother's just saying the whole family virtually is here tonight, and a lot of them. And they're all waiting for each other to catch up with the others. Princess Anne, busy talking. Now to Viktor Banerjee. Going back to have another word with Nigel Havers, by the look of it, too. Very pretty arrangement in Suzanne's hair, holding it back. Well, I think this must be one of the longest lineups we've had at a Royal Film Performance, with five members of the family here. The picture, beautiful picture of the Princess of Wales with Queen Elizabeth the Queen Mother. Interesting, as always, in the films and the people. You can just see the flowers in the hair of one of the little ones who's presenting the bouquets tonight. And yellow and rust coloured, a lot of attention being paid to the films here, to the flowers here tonight. Skirtsing, this is Nivedita Kulkarni, who's 9 years old, Deputy Naval Advisor's daughter in the Indian Commission. And so, in a moment, the Royal Party will enter the auditorium for the 1985 Royal Film Performance of A Passage to India.